Well, it is National Dog Week, and this morning we are spotlighting one of the many amazing local rescue groups here in Northeast Ohio. You probably have heard of them because they've been around for so long. Golden Retrievers in Need, or GRIN for short. And Lisa Keim is here, who is the director and the head of, and also Daria, Yakovone, right. Okay, and you are here with Greta,
yes,
who's a rescue from GRIN. And Lisa, you brought along your rescue too.
This is Radar.
Radar. And Radar, tell us about Radar.
So Radar's blind. He's a puppy mill rescue,
yeah,
and he had eye infections that went untreated.
Oh.
So as a result, he lost his vision. But he has a great life. Don't feel sorry for him.
Yeah, I don't feel sorry for him. He has a sibling at your house.
Yeah, he
and
does.
They kind of rule the roost. I
yes,
do know that.
They do.
So as many of you know, I have another golden retriever who's a rescue from Golden Treasures, yeah, Belle. And I felt like Belle needed a little sister or a playmate. And then I was doing the noon show with Gabe Spiegel, and I was telling him I needed a puppy, a golden puppy. So he gave me your number. And I think, Lisa, within a week, I had little Minnie.
You did.
So thank you.
You're
I'm
very
so
welcome.
Grateful. You guys were on Puppy Watch,
yep,
and I got the call.
Yep.
And tell everyone a little bit about that. Were you able to get little Minnie from?
Yeah, so Minnie is also a puppy mill rescue, and look how good she is.
I'm not going to disturb her because she's being very good.
But she was relinquished by a mill operator because they thought she had a heart murmur. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, with a heart murmur, they're unable to sell them, so they often give them to rescue. So we got the call, and fortunately, she came in, and there was no murmur. Oftentimes, puppies grow out of what we, you know, call a puppy murmur.
Yeah.
So, you know,
yeah. So we're getting her back to health. She's very tiny, hence yeah, her little name with Minnie, because she was anemic and had Giardia and coccidia and some of those icky things that we're still on medicine for,
right,
and figuring out. And Daria, right, I know you've been involved with these guys too, because I did a Zoom call with Daria. She was had to interview me because you have to go through a process. You can't just
right,
call and get one of these dogs. It did take a while. Background checks.
Yeah.
You go into even interviewing my old vet,
yep,
and doing all of that. And then Daria and I got to be friends.
Yeah.
and you did like a house tour and an interview with me to
yes,
see what kind of mom I'd be.
Yes. A wonderful mom.
Thank you. How did you get involved with GRIN?
I got involved with GRIN because we adopted our dog Greta. She also was a puppy mill relinquishment. And we fell in love with her, and then we wanted to help out a little bit more. So we started fostering, and then I took over the applications team as well.
Greta is so sweet. You said she loves puppies, so when she saw little Minnie, she was out of her mind.
Yes, yeah, we have fostered quite a few puppies.
How many dogs have you fostered?
We have fostered 40 dogs.
Oh my gosh.
20 goldens.
And I'm sure that's the tough thing, is that I'm sure, and Lisa, you
yeah,
have fostered so many, and
I
you're
am,
getting another foster.
I am, Sunday.
So how do you not fall in love with them and then need to keep them?
No, you fall in love with every one of them,
aww,
and you cry every time one leaves, even if it's not a good fit for your family. It's my husband that can't let any of them go.
He's already kind of telling you, too,
yeah,
before
yeah,
you've gotten this little
yeah,
biscuit.
Yes.
So you rescue a lot of them from puppy mills. A
we
lot
do,
of them come into a family's home because they think a golden retriever is going to be a perfect dog. And
right,
it's like a big human being in a
right,
fluffy
yeah,
suit. So sometimes it doesn't always work out, and
right,
then people will call you.
About 30% of the dogs that come into our care are relinquished by owners.
Oh.
And, you know, sometimes it's the financial reasons, mm-hmm, it could be personal or health reasons. Oftentimes it's just they got one of these.
Yes.
And they're a lot of work. You know,
yeah,
people have a idea that a golden retriever is sort of like Radar, likes to lay around and take naps, but the reality is they're a lot of work, they have a lot of energy. They're
they
great
can eat
dogs,
your house.
Yes. They're great dogs, but they need training.
Yeah.
And consistency. So
how many rescues? Well, first of all, how long have you been involved with GRIN?
I've been involved about 23 years.
23 years. And how many approximately dogs have you guys rescued over the years?
I would say probably 5,000 or more.
Unbelievable.
Just since January, we've saved 143. So.
Well, I was at West Park Vet yesterday. They help you guys out so much. And amazing. I want to just do a shout out to Dr. Natalie, who is Minnie's doctor. And when I brought her there, because she had spent the night there the night before I got her a month ago, and they all the ladies were so sweet and loving her up. But they give good care and work great with you.
They do. So West Park's our intake facility. Every dog that comes into the rescue goes to West Park. They get, you know, all the medical care they need, and then they go to a foster home or a foster to adopt home. But they've been our partner for, I don't even know how many years, almost since the beginning, and we're celebrating our 32nd year so of rescuing Golden Retrievers. So they're awesome.
Well, you are awesome. And you, the support that I've had with you, and this is my fourth Golden Retriever over 32 years. So, like, I know what I'm getting myself into, but you have been amazing. And even when you're out of the country, I'm still texting you pictures and you're still answering me. So thank you. But you've been so great in assisting me through everything. And when she has the little health issues, you've been so great. And I mean, Grin is just, you guys are wonderful.
Thank you.
I'm just blessed to be part of this. And with Belle, with Golden Treasures, what you guys do every day is just truly amazes me. You guys are great.
We couldn't do it without all the volunteers. I mean, we have a great group of people that are dedicated to this organization and to the breed.
And we have a fundraiser coming up too. Yep. So if you'd like to help, there's the Halloween party.
Yes.
Halloween party coming up on Sunday, October 6th. And there's the information. But you guys have a great interactive Instagram and I know Facebook page.
Yep.
So you can find out more on, because you have a gala coming up too, on how you can help fund these amazing dogs or foster.
Yep.
I'm sure you're always looking for
always
fosters.
Always need fosters, yes.
And of course, more importantly, forever homes.
Yes, adopters. Good adopters.
They're the best. I love you guys.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you for having us.
So great to see you in person. And thank you for giving Minnie such a beautiful, wonderful start. I'm so grateful
for her.
Thank you. Hey, boy, she's so sleepy. She's been playing hard. All right, we're going to take a short break. You're watching Fox 8 News in the morning. You are so sweet. Look.